Hello everyone, today we concern with anticoagulants. Anticoagulants are chemicals or agents which prevents the coagulation of blood. It is of two types, calcium chelators, non-calcium chelators. Calcium chelator is further subdivided into two parts, insoluble calcium chelators, soluble but ionized calcium chelators. So let's talk about insoluble calcium chelators. It is also called oxalate. It is of flowing types, ammonium oxalate, valence oxalate, fluoride oxalate, potassium oxalate. Soluble but ionized calcium chelator is further subdivided into two parts, liquid form and dry form. Liquid form trisodium citrate, whereas dry form ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid, in brief EDTA. Now about non-calcium chelators, heparin, coumarin, warfarin. So let's talk about fluoride oxalate, also called sodium fluoride. It prevents glycolysis by interfering with the enzymes enolase, useful in sugar estimation. Now about EDTA. Commercial name of EDTA, if sodium is used, is borsin, while potassium is used, called sequestrin. Potassium is more soluble than sodium EDTA. That's why more commonly used. K2 is further enhanced by using K3 EDTA. Now about trisodium citrate. Concentration 100 to 120 millimole per liter or 3.2 to 3.8 gram per deciliter. Uses for coagulation study, PT, APTT, fibrinogen product, fibrinogen, ESR estimation by Western Green method. Ratio of trisodium citrate is in ESR estimation by Western Green method is 1:4. While ratio of trisodium citrate in PT, APTT, FDP and fibrinogen is 1:9. Not used for blood cell count, hemoglobin estimation, PCV. So we can say this anticoagulant is coagulation profile test. Now about heparin. It is mucotinin polysulfuric acid, normally present in blood in a small amount, concentration 0.1 to 0.2 mg per ml or 10 to 20 international unit per ml. Uses best for osmotic fragility test. Instantaneous anticoagulant used during open heart surgery. Heparin can be neutralized by protamine. Now about anticoagulant for blood banking. So, citrate dextrose as the anticoagulant used in blood bag, then expiry date of whole blood or packed cell 21 days. If citrate phosphate dextrose is used, then 28 days. If citrate phosphate dextrose adenine used, then 35 days. Now SAGM is in use. Saline, adenine, glucose, mannitol solution. It preserves RBC for 42 days. I hope this clip will be helpful. So please never forget to like, share, comment, subscribe, and also never forget to turn on notification for more update. Thank you. Have a nice day.